Ghosts, goblins, and a skeleton deck out this West Seneca home in Halloween holiday tradition. But it's the spirit inside that keeps the owners on their toes.
I'll be sound asleep and I'll just feel like a cold presence, and it's almost like a touch.
The only thing that made sense was spirits. Somebody didn't want me here.
Dan and Alita Duringer think they may share their home with a ghost. Even their dog Max has had a few close encounters with something. The house dates back to 1928, has a few creaks and moans. But it's what the ghost did to Dan's fiberglass fishing poles in the basement that will really give you chills.
Just came downstairs, like I always do, and here they were, broken into pieces, probably 6 to 8 inches long, and just piled up on the floor here like a little campfire.
Did that totally freak you out, or?
Yeah, at the moment.
And if you were worried about an infestation of ghosts in your house, probably the last place you'd want to live is right next to a cemetery. Who knows what goes on in here in the ghost department, especially at night. This old graveyard has seen better days. Some of these 1800s headstones lean right up against Alita's garden.
There was an old Indian cemetery behind the Ebenezer Cemetery here, and rumor has it that there was a witch that was burned way back when.
But don't expect Alita and Dan to put out the for sale sign anytime soon. That's because Alita grew up in this house. She likes it here. And as a little girl, she even used to play in the cemetery.
So I'm really not afraid, though. It's a little creepy for some other people.
You'd think that growing up next to an old cemetery would prepare one for just about anything in life. But lately, Alita has been a little concerned about the late night wake-up calls.
Oh, and I wake up and I swear I see a face. I see a guy with a beard and curly hair, and it happens to me at least 2-3 times a week. It wakes me up in a sound sleep. My husband sleeps through the whole thing.
On the bright side, living right next to a cemetery, don't suppose you have to worry about noisy neighbors. And as far as Max, Alita, and Dan are concerned, when it comes to their happy and slightly haunted home, there's always room for one more.
So it's a nice neighborhood, but there definitely is, there is a ghost.
In West Seneca, Mike Randall, Eyewitness News.